well. In this video, we are going to see the playing 11 for India against England. This test is really awesome test and that's tough too. So, I am going to say the playing 11 for India and opening batsmen are really required. So, those two batters, the important players who will score many runs for the team, which I think is Rohit Sharma, one of the greatest players. Actually, he played well, but in last test against England, he suffered actually. That too, in the bouncer only he got out. That too, not in a slot ball, or a good length ball, or a short ball. That was a very short ball, which bounced to his head, and saying how much the ball. This was a very delicate short ball, so he pulled. That too, not a pull, that was a swing. He swinged the bat, and in the long mile, he got the catch. So the second innings was tough for him. Mark Wood was the wicket taker of him, and with Rohit Sharma, we of course have three openers. Of course, KL Rahul, Mayank Agarwal, and Shubman. Who can we take? Of course, Mayank Agarwal. In last few matches, he didn't play well, but that's because with his partnership. Because Prithvi Shaw suffered a lot with him. How can I do the partnership? Thought Mayank Agarwal and got out. But Shubman Gill performed awesome. But Shubman Gill performed well in Australia too. But he will perform awesome against Australia. But against England, he suffered when England came to India. Now, they are going to England. So, that's tough. Because the spring conditions are good, so that would be tough. The edge can come from his bat. So I think Mayank Agarwal is one of the players who plays well. On the first test, he got hurt. This third test, I think he will come with the comeback. Okay, he will give a comeback, I'm sure. And at one down, of course, you know that Chetishwar Pujara. He is really awesome. Actually, he scored several 50s and few hundreds too. So, Pujara have played really good games and he is a defensive player. You know that some people ask that why this Pujara is scoring very slowly. That's test cricket. Everybody should keep a defense. So, Chetishwar Pujara is one of the best player in Indian cricket team. And I think that Chetishwar Pujara has played that 50s in a critical situation and helped that India team win. So I think him. And Tudor, who do you think will come? Of course, King Kohli. King Kohli has played awesome games and he is one of the rock stars in the world. Actually, his bat is really strengthened because of him. He is playing really good games and his fielding is really good. Of course, you know that Captain Kohli will definitely play, but he will play in a two-round because he is one of the best batsmen like Pujara, but not a defensive player, he's an attacking player. So he scored runs in this side. By the way, in this side, Pujara will keep defense. So I think this partnership will make the Indian team win the third test match. But I'm not sure. And in a three down, vice captain Ajinkya Rahane. Ajinkya Rahane is an awesome player. You know that? He has played hundreds and against Aussies. He scored a ton, which is really helpful for the team and made India win the cup. That series was really tough, and the second, if they didn't win the second match, then that would be really more tough. And Ajinkya Rahane made the Indian team win by scoring a ton. Rishabh Pant played well, and he's suffering against few players, but against many players he's scoring many runs. So Rishabh Pant is the best keeper nowadays because he has improved his keeping skills, and now he is one of the best keepers, and he is batting well too. In Indian team he is a good batter, so I think he will definitely come. Otherwise we will definitely have, if Rishabh Pant gets hurt, we will definitely have Pradhiman Saha. You will all think, why can't we take Shrikar Bharat? He's new. Why can't we take? No, an experienced player can only play against England. Especially the bowlers are really bowling good swing there. So keeper who will attack and sometimes will play defense can only play. The player who always plays defense cannot play in the conditions, because in any direction the swing can go. So that's the thing. And Pradhiman Saha, he'll also keep defense, but I think Pradhiman Saha is better because in many matches he scored 50 plus, especially against the Asian countries. But of course we have Rishabh Pant. Rishabh Pant is really good player, and you know that, of course, in that 5-down who should come, but who it is, you all think. The answer is not Ravindra Jadeja, because Ravindra Jadeja played awesome, but in that 6-down only he can come, because we need one more batsman, because they're playing well, but they should take some other batsman. Actually, the bowler, especially Mohammad Shami and Jasprit Bumrah played well. Mohammad Siraj also played well. I think Ravindra Jadeja cannot come in this match, but if he comes, we all will be happy. And you know that in a 5-down, there should be an important person to score runs, because in the middle order he is the last person, so he should score some runs. So who will we have? You all think that, now? The answer is, of course, Ravindra Jadeja, because I think Ravindra Jadeja is the suitable person for 5-down. And in that 6-down, I prefer Ravichandran Ashwin. He didn't take many 5-wicket hauls against Australia, South Africa, even England in their countries. But he bowled well, and he has a good wicket-taking opportunity against England. So England's batters are really good. But by the way, our Indian bowlers are really good. Batting, Ravichandran Ashwin will also play well, because he scored a ton against England in the second test. So we all believe that Ashwin will play. And the last one who can bat is the 7-down, because if the bowler comes also, somebody should play. After that, the batters who cannot play will only come. So I think, and I prefer Mohammad Shami. Because in last test, second innings, which is the second best, second innings, he scored a 58 not out, where India got declared in that innings. So I think Mohammad Shami will play in 7-down. And the 8th one, who's that? Of course, Jasprit Bumrah. Bumrah had bowled well, but in last match 30 plus scored and not out. So that's really good, and Jasprit Bumrah will definitely play, because the bowling skills are also good. And in last match, especially when he bowled two fast bouncers, Ollie Robinson got struggled. After he came over the wicket, after that he came around the wicket and bowled a slow delivery which was about the full length, so he got out. So that was a great LBW, and but they didn't give out, but they went for review and got the decision. The review was detailed, and Ollie Robinson has to go at that time. And you know that Jasprit Bumrah is a bowler who bowls with different techniques, and you know, at last, of course, a player should come, then only the innings will get to an end. Of course, Mohammad Siraj, last match, each innings he took 4 wickets. That too important wickets. In last match, in the second innings, if George Butler was there, he would have just defended and would have made a draw. But Mohammad Siraj bowled with delivery that a player cannot play. Even Master the Blaster Sachin will struggle in that ball. That's because that delivery comes in the outside of, next to the stump line, and just bounces. The batsman will think whether touch with the bat or not, and that will definitely be an edge and go to the keeper. So that was great effort by Mohammad Siraj. Mohammad Siraj is of course a great bowler who bowls with different lengths and lines, and he is a good batter too, because in RCB versus SRH, he scored few runs for RCB, and he scored a boundary too. So I think in the eliminator I'm saying, so I think Mohammad Siraj will definitely play. And guys, see you in the next video. Bye bye.